Anderson. Good effort. Oh, that's a fabulous goal. Jordan Henderson with a bolt against the Blues.
Oh, what a screaming goal from Xhaka. Absolutely out of nothing.
Murray Gray, brilliant, brilliant goal.
Also assembled, Ronald Koeman, very experienced. He'll be tested here by Stanislas! Son was fed by Janssen!
Brilliant.
What a start for Spurs! The South Korean makes his mark immediately! Oh, Cahill caught in possession. Big moment this for Alexis Sanchez! Beautifully taken! And Cahill holds his head in his hands.
Lukaku.
Jeff! Pat. Magnificent from Pat. Even better from Pat. It's brilliant from Pat. Can he finish? It's wonderful. West Ham level. Magnificent.
Lukaku the first time in his industry. Saw him rewarded with the second one. William tried to open up the angle. Scores quite magnificently. Well, the goal has been coming, and William provides it.
Alexis. Ozil! Thumps it home!
Directing it back to Sherdan Shaqiri. He thinks he fancies it. Yeah, he does! Oh, why not?
Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 10 of the Premier League Kids Quiz. My name's James Alcott. I will be your quiz master for today's Premier League Kids Quiz. And I can't believe we've got to 10 episodes already. Thanks to everyone who has been watching the Premier League Kids Quiz and has been enjoying it. I hope you have. Testing your Premier League knowledge, and this quiz will be no different. Let's get straight into the action. Let me tell you that there is going to be 5 rounds in this week's Premier League Kids Quiz. As ever, the rounds are as follows. Round 1 will be multiple choice, 3 points available there. Round 2 is the picture round, 7 points available there. Round 3 is the numbers round. We're going to be testing your mathematical skills in this quiz, 5 points available there. Round 4 is where it gets pretty juicy. It's the words round, and there are 9 points available. So make sure you're focused and ready for round 4. And of course, round 5, as ever, is the mystery round. That is right. 5 points available there, 29 points in total in episode 10 of the Premier League Kids Quiz. Make sure you check out all the other Premier League Kids Quizzes if you've enjoyed this one, and make sure you hit that subscribe button for the official Premier League YouTube channel. Right, let's do this, guys. Straight into it. Round 1, question 1. This is the multiple choice round, so we'll give you 3 options. One of those will be the answer, so make sure you're having a guess at the very least, because you could sneak yourself a point, okay? Question 1, which of these stadiums is furthest north? So we mean that geographically. So when you look at England as a country, which one of these 3 stadiums is the furthest north, okay? So you've got 3 options here, A, Molineux, B, St James's Park, or C, Bramall Lane. Now I would love to let you know which teams play at these stadiums, but that's the true test of this question. You need to figure out which club plays at these stadiums to then figure out where they are in terms of which could be the furthest north. So you've got Molineux, who plays there. You've got St James's Park, which Premier League club plays there. And you've got Bramall Lane, of course, another Premier League club plays there. But which one of those 3 stadiums is the furthest north? Question 2 is as follows. Which of these 3 players has never, ever, ever played for another Premier League club? Is it David Luiz? Is it Sergio Aguero? Or is it Mohamed Salah? So which of these 3 players, it is one of them, which of these 3 players has never, ever, 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 you get the point, played for another Premier League club? Is it David Luiz? Is it Sergio Aguero? Or is it Mohamed Salah? Which of these teams does not have red on the current home kit? So which of these teams does not have red, the colour red, anywhere? And by anywhere, I mean anywhere, anywhere, on the current home kit. Is it A, Watford, B, Everton, or C, Crystal Palace? One of these three teams has none of the colour red on their home kit. But which one is it? Is it Watford? Is it Everton? Or is it Crystal Palace? Get your answers down right now and take a breath. That is the end of the opening round. We now move into round two, the picture round. So for round two, you need to make sure that you can see the screen right now because we're going to be showing you some pictures, which you may have guessed because the round's called the picture round. The first question is keep your hair on. Now, I love this one because it's a bit of a styling, bit of a grooming segment in the Premier League Kids Quiz. I really, really love it. And we get to see different Premier League players wearing different hairstyles. So we're going to show you three Premier League players here. Only one of them is wearing their own hair on their head. The other two are just testing it out for this question alone, but hopefully they'll be watching. I'm sure they will. All the Premier League stars like to test their knowledge with the Premier League Kids Quiz. So they'll be looking at this, and it's a new option in terms of a hairstyle for them. Which of these three players has their own hair on their head? So you've got Todd Cantwell of Norwich City, Jack Grealish of Aston Villa, and Lewis Dunk of Brighton. One of them is wearing their own hair on their head, the other two are not. Which one is it, A, B, or C? We've put together a spot the difference question for you here. So this is a picture, or two pictures, from the opening game of the season, Manchester United versus Chelsea. Paul Pogba of Manchester United battling for possession with Mason Mount and Ross Barkley of Chelsea, August the 11th, 2019 at Old Trafford. Now those two pictures, they look very alike, but there are three differences. 3 points available then, for you in this question. Three differences in those two pictures. We want you to identify with your eagle eyes what differences there are in these two pictures. So there's the picture on the left and then the picture on the right. What is the difference, the three differences in the picture on the right to the picture on the left? Battling it out there, Paul Pogba, Ross Barkley, Mason Mount. Have a look. Can you spot the differences in those two pictures? We need three. Write down the three that you can spot, and fingers crossed you'll have three lovely, wholesome points in your back pocket from question two of the picture round. Question three is the Panini puzzle. I love the Panini puzzle, me. We've got three players hidden in that jigsaw. There are 3 points available here because there are three Premier League stars there, so have a look. Little segments of different Premier League clubs, Premier League kits. These are the Panini stickers of these Premier League stars. There are three Premier League stars in there. Can you identify all three? So fingers crossed by the end of this question, you have written down three Premier League players having spotted them from the Panini puzzle that has yet to be completed. Okay, we're into the thick of it now. Round number three, which is the numbers round. Make sure you can see the screen right now. We're going to show you a clip, a whole host of Premier League penalties. Some were scored, some were saved, and some have missed the target. That includes hitting the post and the crossbar, of course. So we're going to show you this clip. We'll show it to you twice. What we want you to do is tally up exactly those three things. Can you tally up the amount of goals that were scored from these penalties, the amount that was saved, and then the amount that were missed? Three columns you'll need to write down. So remember, that's goals scored, penalties saved, and then penalties missed. Okay, let's show you the clip. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. So 3 points are available here. We want the total amount of penalties scored, penalties saved, and penalties missed, which includes hitting the post and the crossbar. Hopefully, from watching it that first time, you've got your initial tallies and you're just calculating them, because we're going to need three numbers for your answers for question one of round three. We'll show you the clip one final time. Question two, we want to know how many different players touched the ball in the clip that we're about to show. It's from the game between Everton and Brighton on the 10th of March 2018. Now remember, if the same player touches the ball twice, it only counts as one. And we are counting players on both teams, both Everton players and Brighton players. So again, the question is, how many different players touched the ball in the clip that you're about to see from the game between Everton and Brighton, okay? Here we go, let's show you that clip. Okay guys, hopefully you've got that initial number there. Now remember, if the same player touches the ball twice, you only count it once. So we'll show you the clip one final time, and I mean it, one final time. Okay guys, question three. We want you to add up the scores from these Premier League matches. These are all the results from a historic match week 10, which you might remember was kicked off with a record equaling win for Leicester City on the Friday night football, with Southampton taking the defeat there. Clean sheet for Leicester City as well, because it was a 9-0 victory away from home. Southampton fans won't want to remember that one, but you're going to have to for this question if you are watching right now. So let me read through the results. What I want you to do is add up all of the goals from these games and give me one number at the end. So we're testing your addition skills here. So we kick off with a big one. Southampton 0, Leicester City 9. Then we move into the Saturday's fixtures. Manchester City winning 3-0 against Aston Villa. Brighton winning 3-2 against Everton, Watford and Bournemouth drawing 0-0, West Ham 1, Sheffield United 1, Burnley 2, Chelsea 4, and then we moved into Sunday, Newcastle United getting a 1-1 draw at home against Wolves, Arsenal drawing 2-2 against Crystal Palace, Liverpool beating Spurs 2-1, and the last fixture from that match week 10, Norwich City 1, Manchester United 3. So the big thing here is counting up all of those goals, adding them up, and giving me one final number at the end of it. A lot of goals that week, but how many exactly? Let me know. That is the final question for the numbers round. We move into round four, 9 points available in the words round, and we're kicking off with a crossword. So for this week's crossword, like every single week, there are three clues, three words that need filling in and 3 points available. There has been one answer put in that crossword already. The answer is Henderson. Henderson, okay? So we'll now give you clues, and actually the letters from that word Henderson could help you out when it comes to getting these questions right. So we're looking for Premier League surnames, remember. Here is your clue. Brighton's Belgian in the middle. Brighton's Belgian in the middle. Now, the fourth letter in that answer is the letter S. That is a second little clue for you there, because that name Henderson is there, the beauty of a crossword. Now, if you get that first one and you've got it right, you'll need to get it right, or you might almost get a secondary clue from understanding the answer of part B. So, part B, the clue is left back at Goodison Park. And you'll get an extra clue for part B if you got question A right. If you think you know the answer to the clue left back at Goodison Park, and you're absolutely certain of that one, only five letters in this one, remember, when it comes to the surname, but if you feel like you know for sure and you're unsure about part A, maybe you've got part A wrong. Yes, mind games, I know. And once again, the answer for part B could affect the answer for part C, or it could help you in terms of you getting the answer for part C. The clue for part C is a Nigerian fox. Just the five letters in that one as well. So if you think you know the answer to part B, if you write that in, the first letter of part C, does that fit into the crossword? Each answer affects the next one. So to run through those clues one final time, part A, we've got Brighton's Belgian in the middle. Part B, left back at Goodison Park. And part C, a Nigerian fox. We need three answers, and there could be 3 points available here for you if you get them all right. Question two, and of course, as ever with the Premier League Kids Quiz, we want to get you spelling. I'm going to get you to spell the following words, three words in fact, and there are 3 points available if you spell them correctly. The first word is energy. So for example, how much energy does N'Golo Kanté have? N'Golo Kanté, Chelsea's midfielder, he can run all day, he's got so much energy. But can you spell that word for me? Energy is the first word that we would like you to spell as part of question two. The second word that we would like you to spell is discipline. So for example, defenders must show good discipline to make sure they're all in the right position at the right time. They're not flying up the field trying to get themselves a goal, running down the wing when they actually need to be back concentrating on stopping the goals instead of scoring them. They need to have discipline. But can you spell that word for us? Tough one, that. Discipline. The final word. It's a long one, but I reckon you're going to be fine. Unbelievable. For example, that goal was unbelievable. The Premier League Kids Quiz, have you tried it out? You should, because it's unbelievable. Am I right? I'm right. So those three words one final time. Energy, discipline, and unbelievable. Question three, it's time for some nonsense names. 3 points available in this one as well. We told you round four, there was lots of points up for grabs. This is where it gets a bit tricky and it gets a bit silly as well. And remember, I can't read these out. So that's almost a clue to you. If you can read them out, I'd read them out aloud if I could, if I was trying to get the answer myself. But you should be doing that yourself. I'm not going to read them out because that way I'll give you a bit more of a clue. You need to figure out these nonsense words and names, turn them into three Premier League players, okay? So here's your first one. So we've got, like I've said in previous quizzes, I'm just going to have to sort of sit back and be quiet here because it's down to you guys. Can you turn those nonsense names into a Premier League footballer? We will, of course, reveal the answers very, very soon. But at the moment, it's down to you. So that's part A. Might even want to write these down if you need a little bit more time to figure out who these Premier League players are from the nonsense names that we're giving you. Here's the second one for you. That's the second one, part B. The best clue I can give you, read them out aloud. Whisper them to yourself. Read them in your head. The sound of how those words come out should take you gently towards or just outside the house of the answer. Yeah, and there it is. You should be going, how can you just then take the little leap to find that Premier League player? So that's the second one for you. The third one is on your screen right now. They're really good this week. Really, really good this week. So again, read them to yourself. Can you figure out who that Premier League player is? There's this that little hop. It's not exactly the same. You need to maneuver these nonsense names to allow you to get the correct answer. It will take you pretty much there, just outside the door. You then got to take the little jump, use your imagination, and figure out that final Premier League player. So there you have it, three nonsense names there, 3 points available. We're looking for three answers. Good luck. It is the final round, the mystery round. That's right. 5 points available here for you. We're going to kick off with an emoji moment. Watch this clip. There will be an emoji over the face of a Premier League player. But which Premier League player is it? That is what you have to figure out. Right, here we go. In 3, 2, 1, let's show you that emoji moment. So a spectacular clearance off the line, but who is hidden underneath the emojis there? That's what we want to know for question one. Question two is where in the world? Now what I need you to do is tell me where in the world each of these three Premier League managers are from and match that up with their flag, okay? So here are your three Premier League managers. We've got Mikel Arteta, Jose Mourinho, and Carlo Ancelotti. Three fantastic Premier League managers, all from different countries. There are three different flags there. We need you to match up the correct flag to the correct nationality of these three Premier League managers. So whenever you're ready, you've got A, B, and C in terms of those Premier League managers. You've got flag 1, 2, and 3. Match them up to the Premier League manager, Mikel Arteta, Jose Mourinho, and Carlo Ancelotti. And question three, the final question in this final mystery round is spot the ball. The ball has disappeared from the game between Everton and Arsenal from February the 23rd, 2020. Dominic Calvert-Lewin of Everton scoring Everton's first goal in that game. Pretty early doors in that game, if I remember rightly. But the ball has disappeared from the image. We want you guys to figure out where exactly the ball is. Now you can use the coordinates. We've got the numbers along the top, letters along the side. Tell me which coordinates work towards the correct square where the ball actually is. When we reveal the answers, we will reveal which square exactly it is, but where do you think the ball is in this image? That is what we want to know for this final question of this week's Premier League Kids Quiz. I did say final question, but actually, I was lying, okay? We've got ourselves a tiebreaker. Of course! It's the Premier League Kids Quiz. We need winners and losers here, okay? And if you are competing against your guardian, against your friends from school, against your football team, whoever it may be, we need to know who is the victor in the Premier League Kids Quiz if you're drawing after the 5 rounds. So let's give you this tiebreaker question, which will decide everything, okay? The tiebreaker question is this. How many free kicks on goal were taken last season in the Premier League? So when it comes to the tiebreaker question, it's whoever gets closest to the correct answer that gets the point. You do very, very well if somehow you know the answer to that. But how many free kicks on goal were taken last season? I will reveal the answer to that at the end of the quiz, of course. I'll also reveal to you how many goals were scored. But what is the correct answer in terms of how many free kicks on goal were taken last season in the Premier League? Write down your answers. Have a think about it. It could be crucial. Right, that's the end of all of the questions. Let's start giving you some answers. Right then, guys, I hope that went well for you. It was a tough one this week, but we're going to give you the answers now. You're going to find out just how well you actually did. Round one was multiple choice. The first question you will remember is, which of these stadiums is furthest north? A, Molineux, B, St James's Park, or C, Bramall Lane? The correct answer is Newcastle United St James's Park, which is just approximately 350 miles north of the Vitality Stadium, which is the furthest south Premier League stadium. Wolverhampton Wanderers play at Molineux and Sheffield United play at Bramall Lane, just for your information. I mean, that's a pretty long walk if you were looking to go from Bournemouth to Newcastle United's St James's Park. But St James's Park is the furthest north. That was the correct answer for question one. Question two, which of these three players have never, ever played for another Premier League club? A, David Luiz, B, Sergio Aguero, or C, Mohamed Salah? The correct answer was B, Sergio Aguero, who has only ever played for Manchester City. David Luiz has played for Chelsea and Arsenal. Mohamed Salah has played for Chelsea and Liverpool in the Premier League. Sergio Aguero, the correct answer there. Question three, which of these teams do not have red anywhere on their current home kit? The options were A, Watford, B, Everton, or C, Crystal Palace. Now, Crystal Palace are famous for their red and blue kits, so it wasn't Crystal Palace. Watford, on their badge, there is a little bit of red. So, of course, the correct answer is Everton, who wear blue and white. No red at all, of course. That's their Merseyside rivals, Liverpool. They wear red. But Everton, it's all blue and white. That is the correct answer for question three. The final question in the multiple choice round, we move into round two, which is the picture round. And the first question you'll remember was Keep Your Hair On, one of my favourites from the Premier League Kids Quiz. We showed you this picture, Todd Cantwell, Jack Grealish and Lewis Dunk there. Only one of them was wearing their own hair on their head. The player that was doing that, Jack Grealish, who has quite a similar haircut to Todd Cantwell. Lewis Dunk, I've never seen him look like that ever before, but it's an option for you now. You've now seen what it looks like, a little preview for you there, but the correct answer was Jack Grealish. Question two was Spot the Difference. Now, we showed you a picture, or two pictures, from the game between Manchester United and Chelsea at Old Trafford, August the 11th, 2019. You had Paul Pogba tussling for possession with Mason Mount and Ross Barkley. We wanted to know the three differences from the picture on the left to the picture on the right. Here are the three differences that we were looking for. First up, the white wristband on Pogba's arm on the left-hand side has changed colour. It's turned red with the picture on the right. The second difference is that there is no stripe on Mason Mount's left sock. You've got that stripe on the right, but not on the left sock. And the final difference, quite a big one, this one, Anthony Martial is in the background of the picture on the left-hand side, but he's been replaced by a referee, Michael Oliver, on the picture on the right-hand side. So those were the three. Question three was a Panini puzzle. We can now complete that Panini puzzle and show you the three players that we wanted you to identify. Those three players were Gerard Deulofeu of Watford, Danny Ings of Southampton, and Song Heung-min of Tottenham Hotspur. 3 points available in that question and 3 points available in the first question of round three. Now, we showed you a clip of a whole host of penalties. We wanted to know how many of those missed the target, how many of those were saved, and how many of those were scored. Let's show you that clip again, revealing the answers. So there you have it. Three goals were scored from those penalties, four were saved, and three missed or hit the woodwork, which counts as a miss in my book. And as Quizmaster, I create the book, okay? And the correct answers are three goals, four saves, and three misses. Three correct answers there. You get a point for each one you got correct. Let's move on to question two. We showed you a clip from the game between Everton and Brighton on Saturday, the 10th of March, 2018. What we wanted you to do was count the amount of players that touched the ball. And we wanted you to count players from both sides, so Brighton and Everton. And if a player touched the ball twice, you only counted them once. Let's show you the clip again and reveal the answer. So there you have it, the correct answer was seven. If you put down seven, you got yourself a point. Well done to you. We move into question three, where we showed you an iconic match week. Match week 10 of this Premier League season, which kicked off with that very famous record-equaling win for Leicester City away from home at Southampton. 9-0 in that one, but we wanted to know what was the total amount of goals scored in this weekend's action. I went through all those fixtures there that you can see in front of you right now, and the correct answer was 38. 38 goals in that historic match week. Obviously, a lot of those coming from Leicester City to the detriment of Southampton, but the correct answer was 38. You get yourself a point if you wrote those two numbers together, 3 and 8, 38. Into round four, which was the word round, 9 points available here. We kicked off with a crossword. Part A of that crossword that we were looking for you to fill in. We gave you a clue. Brighton's Belgian in the middle. The correct answer, Trossard. Trossard, the Brighton midfielder. Part B of that crossword, the clue was left back at Goodison Park. The correct answer, Lucas Digne, or Digne in particular. For the second part and the third part of this crossword to complete it, to fill in a crossword, a Nigerian fox was the clue. Leicester are the Foxes. A Nigerian that plays for the Foxes? It's Ndidi. Ndidi it is. That was the correct answer. 3 points available there, so we were looking for Trossard, Digne and Ndidi. Question two, we asked you to spell the following words. Energy, discipline and unbelievable. You spell those words like this. Energy is spelt E-N-E-R-G-Y. If you spell that right, you get yourself a point. The second word that we want you to spell, discipline. D-I-S-C-I-P-L-I-N-E. That is how you spell discipline. A few hidden sounding letters in the word discipline, but if you got that right, well done to you, you get yourself a point. And the final word, unbelievable, is spelt like this. U-N-B-E-L-I-E-V-A-B-L-E. Unbelievable. If you got that right, you're unbelievable. And you get yourself a point and a pat on the back. Go on, do it. Give yourself a little pat. Congratulations. Well done, guys. If you got that right, that was the word unbelievable. And then it all got a bit silly, didn't it? If we're honest, for question three, with nonsense names, as it does every time that it's in the Premier League Kids Quiz. So I can now say it out loud, which will hopefully help, although in the past I've struggled with this myself. Here we go. Part A of nonsense names. Sebastian and Holler. Sebastian Holler. Sebastian Haller. That's the first player that we were looking for. Sebastian Holler. Close enough, right? Part B. I live here, hey, Giroud. I live here, hey, Giroud. Olivier Giroud. Olivier Giroud was the correct answer. Like I said, there's that little leap of faith that you've got to do. You've got to use the creativity and the imagination that you have. And the final nonsense name. Hand draws Tan's End. Hand draws Townsend. Andros Townsend. Yeah. That was a bit closer. Andros Townsend. If I say it quickly, it does sound like Andros Townsend. The correct answer for part C of the nonsense names was Andros Townsend. Correct answer for each of those three nonsense names that you got correct. We move into the mystery round, the final round. 5 points available here, and we kicked off with an emoji moment from the game between Cardiff City and Tottenham Hotspur. But who was the Tottenham defender with emojis on top of their head performing a spectacular goal line clearance? Let's show you the clip again without the emojis and reveal the answer. So there you have it, Toby Alderweireld with the goal line clearance there. Superb defending from the Belgium. He was hidden by emojis, but no more. He's been released from having that emoji over his head. And there you go, he gets to get the glory himself, Toby Alderweireld there. And if you wrote down Toby Alderweireld, you got yourself a point. We move into question two. Where in the world? Now I needed you to tell me where in the world each of these Premier League managers were from. And then I needed you to match up the three flags that we offered up to that Premier League manager. So let's start off with the Premier League managers. We had Mikel Arteta, Jose Mourinho, and Carlo Ancelotti. Mikel Arteta is from Spain, Jose Mourinho is from Portugal, and Carlo Ancelotti is from Italy. So Mikel Arteta is from Spain. Flag three is the Spanish flag. So if you matched up flag three with Mikel Arteta, you get yourself a point. Jose Mourinho is from Portugal. Flag number two is the Portugal flag. So if you matched up flag two with B, Jose Mourinho, you got that right, which of course leaves us with flag number one, which is the Italian flag. And Carlo Ancelotti is from Italy. So you would have wanted to match up flag one with C. If you did that, you got yourself a point. If you got all of those correct, you got yourself 3 points. Well done to you. We finish off round five with Spot the Ball. This Spot the Ball picture, it's Dominic Calvert-Lewin scoring for Everton against Arsenal, but the ball was missing. We wanted you to give us the correct coordinates to reveal where exactly that ball would actually be. It was a belter of a bicycle kick from Dominic Calvert-Lewin, so the ball was in the square A3. A3 was the correct answer in the Spot the Ball question. If you wrote down A3, if you remember that goal, that might have given you a bit of a clue. But A3 was the correct answer. You get yourself a point. Last up, we've got to give you that tiebreaker answer, because if you are drawing at the moment, then you're going to need it, aren't you? You're going to need it. You'll remember that we asked you how many free kicks on goal were taken last season in the Premier League. So if you're drawing with someone right now, whoever gets closest when it comes to the tiebreaker, you get the point and you get the victory. Here is the answer of how many free kicks on goal were taken last season. The correct answer, 354. 354. How many goals were scored? 23. Only 23 last season from those 354. So it really is, if you get to witness a free kick being scored, it's something very special, because it doesn't happen that often. Fingers crossed you got closer than your opponent. Obviously, you can't both do that, otherwise it'd be a draw again. I don't know what to do after that. But that is the answer to the tiebreaker question, 354. So there you have it, another Premier League Kids Quiz done and dusted. I hope you have enjoyed the Premier League Kids Quiz. If you want to take on all of the other, there are 9 other Premier League Kids Quiz on the Premier League YouTube channel for you to enjoy. And spoiler alert, I am your quiz master for every single one of them. So why not check them out, test your Premier League knowledge. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the like button and of course, subscribe to the Premier League YouTube channel. Thank you so much for joining in. You've been fantastic. I've been James Alcott. I'll see you next time.